What is going on, everyone? This is Ninja Geek here. Welcome back to another video, and today we're going to have some Modern Warfare Remastered gameplay in the background, so I hope you do all enjoy that. I have gone back to Modern Warfare Remastered yesterday, and it was a pretty fun experience, and if I ever get the itch to play COD again until Modern Warfare 4 comes out or whatever happens, which we will be discussing in this video, I probably will play Modern Warfare Remastered, or if not, I'll probably go back and play World War II. I kind of want to go back and see how the game has aged over this amount of time, and I know that, of course, Dying Food on Twitter says that, and on YouTube as well. He just thinks that Sledgehammer, as of right now, is the best COD developer, and that World War II is a great game. And I don't really agree with those things. Of course, I don't think that World War II is the worst thing that ever happened to Call of Duty, but it definitely isn't something that has been remarkable within the Call of Duty franchise. I mean, when a lot of people think about World War II, they think about the horrible launch that the game had, and the fact that it was really bad for at least a good solid 3 to 4 months, maybe even more, until Condrey and Schofield actually left the team, and they moved up in Activision. But, so World War II, I want to go give that a try again. I don't think it was as bad in its final form as it was when it came out, but the maps and the streaks are still two huge things that are kind of weaker in that game. So we'll see how I enjoy it if I go back to it. But anyways, nonetheless, today I want to talk about some theories that, of course, a lot of fans have been talking about recently, that you probably heard of the theory that Modern Warfare 2 Remastered will come into Modern Warfare Remastered as some type of update, which is why they made the game free to play for the month on PlayStation and all these things like that. Maybe because, of course, we know that they have the campaign remastered on the... They leaked it, of course, on the PEGI website, so we know it's a game, we know it's coming, but it did not have multiplayer, so people are speculating that maybe the multiplayer version of Modern Warfare 2 Remastered will come in the form into the original Modern Warfare Remastered. And at first, I was completely against this, because the thing about it is right, you're talking about an older game, you're talking about continuity between the games, so why would they release a separate game and then have the other one be attached to something else? At first, I was kind of hesitant, like, why would you do something like that? It just doesn't really make a lot of sense. And, of course, from an Activision standpoint and how they want to get money, how could, being in the same game generate them more money? They would rather release it as a standalone, but the fact that they're not really leaked and supposed to do that, and they're only supposed to do it for a campaign, it just, nothing really adds up. But I do see the fact that now, fans are still talking about this theory that it could go into Modern Warfare Remastered as some type of update. Or now, when I mean into Modern Warfare Remastered, I've seen people talk about this as well. I don't think that they would implement the things from Modern Warfare 2 into Modern Warfare Remastered. I think what I mean by that is that there will be a menu, a separate playable, multiplayer menu for Modern Warfare 2, so you click if you want Modern Warfare Remastered, and then if you want Modern Warfare 2 Remastered, they're two separate things, sort of like how Halo the Master Chief Collection is. I think that would be the way that they would go about it. I don't think they're going to have a mishmash of Modern Warfare 2 into Modern Warfare Remastered. I just don't think that that's going to happen. And we know that there are things, and they've been working on Modern Warfare 2, of course, because things over time during Modern Warfare Remastered's life cycle have been added into the game files, such as, the attachments for Modern Warfare 2 and guns and all that, those types of stuff, which you probably already know about. So, all in all, right now, what do we know? We know that Modern Warfare 2 Remastered is coming. We know the campaign is on its way because we have seen the leak from the PEGI website, so that's pretty much all but confirmed. The multiplayer, though, there's been a lot of theories, and I could agree with something like this coming into Modern Warfare Remastered, but ultimately, I'm just not entirely sure. It's just, we're going to have to wait and see, and right now, we don't even know who is developing Modern Warfare 2 Remastered, because I did hear from somewhere, I'm not entirely sure, I don't think it was, of course, Activision or anything official, but I heard that Raven was not developing Modern Warfare 2 Remastered, and this was a long, long time ago. Things could have changed, and who else would honestly develop Modern Warfare Remastered? They already made the first one, or Modern Warfare 2 Remastered, I should say. They already made the first one, so why wouldn't they have the ability to make the second one? And the other theory that I have personally that I think is going to tie everything together here is the fact about what Activision actually did confirm at their quarter, whatever the quarter was, the last press conference that they had for the earnings, where they talked about COD 2019 having a campaign, a robust multiplayer, and an expansive co-op experience. What Activision actually did confirm there, which kind of pulls everything in the Call of Duty franchise together when we really step back and think about it, and a couple other people might have talked about this. I haven't really seen it floating around anywhere, so I just want to get your opinion on this. But Activision did confirm and say that they're working to try and expand their developer base, so that basically what I am trying to say here is that the developers have more interaction between each other, so they could use different things between the games, between the developing studios, that they could use more help, they could get more help between them. So maybe this is just, it could be a far-fetched theory, I'm not entirely sure, but it makes sense in my mind, so I figure I'd share it. But maybe Treyarch and Sledgehammer are in fact working with Infinity Ward to develop COD 2019, Modern Warfare 4, Modern Warfare 2 Remaster Campaign, whatever you want to call it, as a bundle, whatever that is coming, and it's going to be announced hopefully pretty soon. Maybe they are developing the game with them, and it would make a lot of sense. Now, of course, we don't really know anything about Sledgehammer's next game or anything like that, so there's nothing really to talk about with them. But with Treyarch, we know that Black Ops 4 is their current game, right? And to put it lightly, Black Ops 4 has such little content, and when the game launched, it didn't have as much content as their older Treyarch games. Every single Treyarch game, including Black Ops 3, Black Ops 2, Black Ops 1, even World at War, and even from Nero, I heard, even COD 3 had more content at launch than Black Ops 4 does, and the fact that there are such little content in Black Ops 4, a lot of fans are just straight up quitting the game. I left the game, of course, I'm not going to talk about it here, but the specialists, and I can't wait for the No Specialist playlist so that hopefully I can return to the game, but a lot of people are actually leaving because there's just nothing to do. There's no content that they're pushing out for the game. You know, it seems like, at one point, you know, on one hand, it's like, is Activision only caring about the greedy side of the company, which of course we know they are, because now with Operation Shamrock and all, they've released a $20 COD point pack for do with cosmetic skins and stuff for Shamrock and all, but there's no free content or contraband stream or whatever you want to call it, and people are rightfully pissed off about that. So there is some content in that form, but my theory is that I think that this is true, because if we look at everything that Treyarch's done, you're not going to tell me. I mean, at first I thought, okay, maybe, you know, they went too far. Of course, they had to scrap campaign, and then they had to get people from both the multiplayer and zombies teams to come work on Blackout, so they're stripped thin between the game modes, and that's what I originally thought. Okay, you know, maybe they're stripped thin, maybe that's why they're not releasing as much content in a timely fashion, but we are talking about Treyarch, we're talking about Activision, we are talking about a AAA studio here, okay? They have enough resources, if they wanted to be able to push out enough content. I mean, let's be honest here. So the only thing that I could think of is if Treyarch and Sledgehammer as well are actually working on Infinity Ward on Modern Warfare 4, or like I said, whatever the game is. And that would make a lot of sense, because there's not a lot of content in Black Ops 4. Maybe Activision was like, yo, like, we need some help. We want to build a great Call of Duty game here. Go help out Infinity Ward. Get some assets in there. You know, get some team members in there. And that would explain why we're experiencing a deficit in Black Ops 4 of content-wise. You know, there still is content in the game that is somewhat being updated, but it is nowhere near as frequently as World War 2. And Activision literally said in their earnings call that that's what they were trying to do. They're starting the thing of building the developers and trying to get them to work more together, at least from the summed up notes and things that I've heard from Charlie Intel on this and that. That's what they were trying to do. And maybe this is the start of that. Maybe Call of Duty won't have a 3-year development cycle anymore. Maybe Modern Warfare 4 is something even bigger than we even think it is. Maybe it's just not Modern Warfare 4. Maybe it is like something like a Halo Master Chief Collection, where instead of it coming to Modern Warfare Remastered, Modern Warfare 2 Remastered comes inside of Modern Warfare 4, and it's this big Modern Warfare universe with an expansive, huge multiplayer, and of course a co-op mode with Spec Ops and this and that. Who knows what we could be getting this year? It's really out in left field. Like last year, when we got Black Ops 4 was announced, of course, I would have just 100% assumed, and I did for months, that, oh, it was just going to be Black Ops 4. Treyarch has always done Black Ops. I mean, it's just going to be Black Ops 4. And of course, it was Black Ops 4, and there really wasn't much speculation about, oh, what the game is going to be. Of course, there was a big thing about having no campaign, which is probably the biggest thing at this time. But this year, we have so many things that are just outside of anyone's reach. We don't know what the game is. Of course, I think it's going to be Modern Warfare 4, but there could be so many options on the table. A lot of people have already shut down that it's not going to be Infinite Warfare 2. It's not going to be Ghost 2. Of course, we have from the Activision earnings call again saying that it's going to be rooted with franchise past and franchise history, and that could only really mean the Modern Warfare series, because Infinite Warfare didn't make franchise history, and Ghost really wasn't franchisable in the history. We're really talking about the Modern Warfare franchise here, so I do believe it's going to be something with Modern Warfare, and Treyarch and Sledgehammer are somehow working extensively with Infinity Ward on this game. But let me know your thoughts on what you think about this. Do you think it could be something that is actually true, that, yeah, you know, Treyarch could be doing that, and that's why we're not getting as much content in Black Ops 4? I mean, it's still no excuse why Black Ops 4 doesn't have enough content in it from day one, let alone right now, but it's no excuse for it. I'm not saying, oh, that's, you know, it's okay to do it that way. But at the same time, I think that this is what's going on, and it's what explains why there's so little content in Black Ops 4 at the end of the day. But you can let me know your thoughts on that down below, and I hope you did enjoy the Modern Warfare Remastered gameplay. And I think I covered everything I wanted to in this video, and I guess how it ties into Modern Warfare 2 Remastered is the fact that, of course, if Treyarch and Sledgehammer are working, maybe some of the team and some of the developers, including Raven as well, are working on Modern Warfare 2 Remastered, and it's going to come in the form of Modern Warfare 4, or it's going to be an update to Modern Warfare Remastered, which may have been why it's a free game of the month for PlayStation. It could have just been a coincidence that the game is free, but honestly, when has a Call of Duty game ever been the game of the month, like on Xbox or PlayStation? I think this is a first, at least to my recollection, I think it's the first, so it could be a sign of things to come in the future. But right now, everything in this video is just all speculation, and it's just out 5,000 different windows right now. We have no idea about anything, but it will be interesting to see how all of this plays out, how, you know, we get the next reveal for the next Call of Duty game, who's going to be exactly working on it, and, you know, maybe they'll come out and even say, you know, we're developing this game with Treyarch and Sledgehammer to make this giant Call of Duty game, and then we don't even know what's going to be interesting to also see about Modern Warfare 2 Remastered and how the campaign of the aspect plays out, and leading on from that, really how the multiplayer remastered will turn out to be, because we have no idea about any of this stuff right now, but it's all just speculation. So let me know your thoughts down below anyways, and I will see you on the next one. This is Ninja Geek, I'm out, and peace.